Greetings, fellow Uzbekistan. Welcome back to Results of Fools. Today's mission at hand is Copperhead, in which we are going to retrieve a reconnaissance box from a downed F-18. Now, this is vital to us because it will, you know, give us a lot of information about basically the ongoings in the area. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and retrieve intelligence on our targets. Well, that is a long insertion. Actually, the extraction is a pretty long route, so I'm guessing they will be focusing on extraction in this mission. Or so, I suppose, you never know. Recover the reconnaissance box from a downed F-18 close to Bravo Team's forward deployed area of responsibility. Bravo Team's forward deployed area of responsibility? What? Am I, like, keeping a watch there or something? Execution. A reconnaissance F-18 has gone down near Bravo Team's current position. Current position? Huh? What? Oh, so we were literally just out on the field patrolling or doing something along those lines, and F-18 just went down right there, and we've been tasked with an emergency mission. I see. You will leave your position and head east following the GPS coordinates transmitted to you. The pilot ejected and landed in the Spetsnaz area of responsibility. I see. In order for this mission to be successful, we must locate the airplane, recover the orange box, which is actually the black box, but it's orange in color, and destroy any enemy units in the immediate area. Once you have recovered the box, you must get it to the extraction point in order for this mission to be considered a success. I added a few words there. Expected enemy forces. The combat search and rescue mission coordinator reports that the enemy air mobile troops have entered the area near the crash site and are conducting extensive ground searches for the downed aircraft. In addition, radio intercepts indicate that a mercenary special operations capable team is in the area. Mercenary team, huh? And that too, special operations capable team, I see. Worthy adversaries, I suppose. However, the presence of enemies looks pretty thin on this map. Who knows, I mean, it seems that there are pretty few enemies thus far, at least, in the Uzbekistan campaign, from what I can tell. Allied support. Alpha team is approximately 500 meters from the crash site. They will head due north from their position towards the crash site, eliminating any enemy units that they encounter, basically dying while doing it, I suppose. Situation. In advance of large-scale air operations in the vicinity of Kosboget, the Divisional Command Search and Rescue Mission Coordinator has received approval of a tasking order placing special forces units in forward deployed positions for downed aircrew rescue. Subsequently, U.S. Marine F-18s, using the newly operational Advanced Tactical Air Reconnaissance System (ATARS), have been conducting extensive reconnaissance missions in the sector. I just realized I'm sort of reading like an AI because, it's difficult for me to focus at this time. At mobile. The primary goal is to identify the convoy routes the enemy uses to carry supplies to the front. Combat search and rescue reports that one such plane has gone down. The pilot ejected and landed in the Spetsnaz area of responsibility. You have already told us that. It is imperative that the orange box be recovered as black box. Call it a black box because that's like the proper term for it, even though it looks orange. Be recovered as the data in it is vital to stopping enemy resupply. But then again, I suppose they're telling us that the box is orange because, pretty much what I wanted. This game was not exactly meant for veterans who would know the color of a black box. But anyway, let's see. I wonder if the plane is something that you can physically enter into. But why is the Black Hawk here? Why is the Black Hawk dropping me here? The Black Hawk is not supposed to be here. These are some really pretty houses.
Blackwood at a King 6. All insertions are complete. Head into the house.
Godspeed, Blackwood. Now, these are some like really pretty houses, and I mean, I actually want to stay in some of them. I want to live in some of them. These look superbly pretty. Whatever you said. I can see all the troops rallying towards me. Maybe I should not have done that. Perhaps I will live to regret this. This foolish action of mine. I can already hear fire pinning me down. Ah, there you guys are. Oh, is that the plane? I see. Okay, that's your buddy over there. Now, the neat part of this game is, as long as you are in cover, the enemies, they will not tackle you, like, head-on. They will try to get into a position where they can shoot at you. And, yeah, there's almost zero concept of suppressive fire on this. There are, like, multiple enemies here. That guy looked different. I don't know why, but that guy looked different. And where am I getting shot from? Is it from the back? Is it from this? Actually, I should probably hide myself before I decide to... Oh, there you are. That guy also seemed a little different, actually. I don't think I've seen folks like that. Let me just hide myself again and check the area. Does not seem to be anybody here. There are some threats over there, but I suppose what I'll do is I'll climb up that mountain and go check for threats. Now, I do have half a magazine, so I'm not going to go ahead and load just yet. Reload, I mean. Yeah, dead guy. That seems to be the plane, or at least the tail of the plane, because I cannot see the rest of the plane from there anyway. But yeah, it seems to be a part of the plane. Which part, I don't exactly know. I'm just gonna scale up this mountain, and I'm gonna try and take care of the rest of the enemies up there. Sometimes you really have to climb mountains, like climb these mountains. There's like literally no way around it. Now these guys are firing, I don't know what they're firing at. Because I don't suppose they can see me, can they? Oh, they can. I think they're trying to nail me. Maybe they were. Okay, somebody has spotted me. Somebody has spotted me, I don't know who exactly. Yeah, these guys are different. I guess this is what they were saying when they said Spec Ops accomplished mercenaries. I've got like an unlimited amount of shots to practice hitting this guy. That guy's already dead, no need to bother with him. That guy's not dead yet though. And that guy looks like a spec ops, so I probably should be a little more cautious in dealing with him. There should be a person over here. Alpha 1? What are you doing all the way over there? You're dead. Oh, come on. You need to die. You can die easier. Come on. It's not that difficult. Now, I do have somebody over here. Oh, there you are. And this should be... That is Alpha 1 and 2. And surprisingly, they're not dead. What a surprise. Like, what a pleasant surprise indeed. These guys are finally dead. And anybody else remaining on the map, or is the area ours? For now it is, until we get to the extraction point. That is indeed the plane, the entire plane, not just the tail. Now, where do we search for the black box? Ah, good thing I did not die. So, just one of the many things that I've noticed about this game, it does not have fall damage. It has zero fall damage, and I suppose they did not know how to... Ah, there it is, conveniently lying
good
outside.
Job, Bravo. Move to the extraction point.
Of,
King 6 to all elements, objective secured. Move to primary extraction point.
Roger, King 6.
Roger that, King 6. Black Widow is moving out.
Yeah, and, my allies... What? Oh, yeah. And that guy is saying the same lines that these guys were saying. And I wondered for a moment there as to how they know our locations. But that guy's on. And like, who's there? Because nobody was supposed to be there, right? Nobody's over there anymore. I took care of those people. There should be some people over there though. Can't see any yet. Cannot see any just yet. But what I will do is I will go go around. I won't be tackling them from this pit here, because this is pretty much a death trap. This is plain open fields with little to no cover at all. And I do suppose somebody's shooting at me as well, because I can hear the bullets whizzing past me. Where are these guys shooting? Hey, where are you guys shooting? Don't shoot me. Why are you shooting me? I'm on your side. Come on. Do you think I'm deserting you or something? Come on, man. Have some faith in me. We've been through so much together. Actually, we haven't. We've mostly been dying for the most part. But I understand you're frustrated, but you don't need to kill me. We can talk this out. Come on. There are other enemies that you need to address first. Or are you guys the traitors? Do you wish to have the black box for yourself then? Alpha 1 and 2. I shall remember your names. I can hear some enemies here. I don't know where they are, but I can hear them. Now, one of the reasons that I did not want to go down this the straight road was it's super exposed. I think I've already told you guys this, but I'm just going to say that again for the sake of repeating it. It's super exposed. Not exactly an advisable route for me to take. It's literally like walking into a death trap. You've got mountains on all sides, high ground on all sides, and you're literally walking in the low ground, and then at an angle where the enemy can easily get to you. So yeah, I would rather avoid the area as much as possible. Now, I don't particularly like where I am right now either, but it's better than being down there. I suppose I should probably move up this or that mountain, either of them, and clear the objective, clear the area near the objective before I proceed to extraction, because I need to do it anyway. So yeah, let's proceed up this mountain. The longer route is usually the better one in these games, but sometimes following the shorter route can be the key to solving your problems. And when, you know, trying the longer route does not work out, I mean. Because unless, in most cases, unless, the route was meant to be traveled, it's got like these super steep slopes and you need to climb onto them like as if you're driving a car up a hill. So yeah, you can sort of have an idea of whether the route was meant to be or not. That sounded like a kid. Oh my god, did I kill a kid? I don't want that on my conscience. That guy's dead. That guy's also dead. And I would like to stay up here for a while. Yeah, there are some people in there. I don't know where, because it's super difficult to see them inside these tents. Inside the tents that they're in. But this guy... Okay, this guy... No, that guy was a kid. Wasn't he? Should be another one of his buddies down there. I don't know where, but somewhere over there. Is this guy saying sugary dish? Because that is sort of what it sounds like. Sugary dish. Or maybe the guy is down here somewhere. Maybe I should just use a grenade. Oh, there you are. How did you survive that grenade blast, huh? And I could almost tell where that shot came from. Impressive. Now, what I want to do is be a little cautious in how I approach this, because otherwise it can get pretty difficult. I think the shot came from somewhere in there. Now, I need to be expressly careful while going down these steps here, because it can literally be make or break. Yes, Oh, come on. Thought that might be too far. This isn't working. I'll probably have to slowly make my way down and precisionally try to eliminate any enemies that I see. I know for sure that there is an enemy down there, but this guy does not exactly seem to be a threat to me. Not at this stage anyway. There are only three enemies remaining at this point in time. Two are inside inside of this tent here, and one of them is somewhere inside that. I mean, one of them is right there. So, but the problem is, I can't exactly hit either of them because bullet penetration is not a thing in this game. And yeah, if you can't see it, you can't hit it. It's basic water. Then you need to follow. One of you was there. Makes me wonder. Is your buddy there as well? Huh? Yes, he is. Your buddy is right there. So I suppose you guys are not in there, after all. And I suppose I can clear that guy out as well. Although I would have to exercise quite a bit of caution, because, like I said, clearing people, clearing rooms and stuff in this game, very difficult. Extremely difficult. I was targeting the wrong place all this time. Huh. I thought I felt like that bullet came from somewhere down there. I thought about it, and then I, you know, dismissed it, thinking that maybe, you know, these guys are probably inside these tents. Which they aren't, which they won't. So, anyway, and now that this camp is clear of everything, let's just reload and proceed towards extraction. Might be some folks around still, who knows. You never know. But yeah, this is just one of the many advantages of having your map open right in front of you, because
the Blackwood and Bravo, our ETA is 5 mics. I repeat, 5 mics.
You guys literally left from base around 15 minutes ago, but your ETA is still 5 mics. But I'm guessing they said that because they don't exactly want the Black Hawk to come and pick us up right now. At any rate, Alpha 1 and 2 are still in favorable. They haven't proceeded to extraction at all. So yeah, we will consider this mission a success. And at the first try at that, is this game improving or what? I mean, it feels like the level design in this game has certainly improved, at least the balancing aspect. Anyway, I digress. Let's go ahead and read the mission briefing. I was about to hit space bar again. 26 kills. I don't know how many Alpha team killed, but I think they did kill one or two. Not that many enemies. See, like, there aren't that many enemies in these levels anymore. Excellent work, Bravo team. It was imperative that a new intelligence gathering system not fall into enemy hands. The intelligence that you have recovered is proving to be invaluable. We are now aware of how the enemy is conducting their supply convoy missions. From the intelligence gathered, we have been able to determine the routes that they are using. Specialized forces are currently planting acoustical sensors in those areas. I see, you literally like implant them into rocks and stuff. I see. So they are like radar or leader. Bravo team, I don't know, I still don't know what leader is yet though. Bravo team is assigned the elimination of convoys in the vicinity of Cosbuket that the sensors pick up. Roger. And that unlocks yet another mission for us at the very end of Uzbekistan called Diamondback. Bravo team will destroy an enemy supply convoy near Gulistan, probably this country right here. And this is another convoy ambush mission. Ambush and destroy an enemy armored column that is reported to be in the vicinity of Ushse. I don't know what that is at all. Ushse. Uralsi? I don't know. I don't know. Aralsi. I've got no clue at all. Anyway, that was that for this mission. The next time we come around, we have a choice between three missions: Junkhead, Juggernaut, and Corridor. I think I should go for Junkhead because we had read about the enemy power generation unit at the start of Mission Raven, so I will first ambush the enemy power generation unit, and then we will decide between whether to pursue Juggernaut first or Condor first. Now I am sort of inclined to do this first, because otherwise that's two ambush missions back to back. But yeah, let's see how we do it and what we do. So yeah, thanks for tuning in today. Thank you for watching me play. Which mission did we complete? Copperhead. That's right, I completely forgot about it. Thank you for watching Copperhead, and I will see you guys later. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow things.